Thank you all for joining me this evening. This is Michael, and welcome back to the channel. Well, everyone, do you know what today is? Today is September 8th. Now, I know that many of you are probably thinking, September 8th? What happened on September 8th? Well, let me calm you all's nerves, because it was nothing tragic. Now, September 8th may not have very much of a meaning to most of you listening to me, but to a Star Trek fan, September 8th is a very holy day. Because that was the day that the original Star Trek, way back in 1966, premiered on television with its first episode, The Man Trap. And as they say, the rest is history. Being the anniversary date of the release of the original Star Trek, I felt compelled to give my thoughts on the franchise today and how I feel about the original series and its impact on not just Star Trek and science fiction, but me as a human being and the world today. Now, September 8th, 1966. I was very much too young to see Star Trek when it first premiered. And my earliest thoughts go back to maybe 6 or 7 years old when I caught the show for the very first time. The episode was "Let This Be Your Last Battlefield." And many Star Trek fans dismiss that episode as being perhaps one of Star Trek's worst. But I have a very, very different opinion of that episode. You see, it dealt with, believe it or not, race relations. It dealt with prejudice, hatred. It dealt with the differences that we all have, and those differences keep us separated, oceans apart. And I've always felt like that episode is most certainly underrated. I mean, you think about Star Trek. You think about over 50 years ago, Star Trek was trying to teach us that we needed to get along. Star Trek was trying to teach us that we needed to work through our differences and come together and celebrate those differences. Over 50 years ago, Star Trek was telling us that we needed to work through all the bullshit and learn how to accept and love one another. And what's really sad about Star Trek is that premiering all those years ago and having a message of hope, this day in 2020, the message of Star Trek is more relevant than it has ever been. And it's sad, because you have to sit back as a fan, as a human being, as a person, and wonder how far will we have to go before we learn to accept one another instead of always fighting against one another. So, Let This Be Your Last Battlefield left an impression on a 7-year-old kid. And I have very, very strong feelings about the episode, and watching it today, it is more powerful than it has ever been. I've always loved Star Trek. I've always loved what Star Trek stood for. I've always loved the fact that Star Trek was hopeful. It presented us with this future that said, you know, mankind will get along. There'll be no hunger. There'll be no prejudice. There'll be no negative race relations. We'll all learn to accept each other, and we'll all grow from our differences. That's a very, very hopeful message. It's a message that is so much needed today. And those characters, those relationships, those people, you think of that future and you think, you know, given all that happens in today's world, I sometimes sink into this depression to where I feel like, you know, is Star Trek just a dream? Will we ever get to a point where we will accept each other and all this freaking hatred and prejudice and this strife over differences? Will this shit ever end? Star Trek says it will. And that's a very, very powerful message. It's a message that we need today. And it's a message that, unfortunately, the newer Star Trek shows, Star Trek Discovery, Star Trek Picard, Star Trek Lower Decks, it's a message that the people that are in control of Star Trek now have forgotten. Star Trek isn't hopeful. Star Trek doesn't look to the future and say that we will not only make it to the future, but we will make it together. Without prejudice, without hunger, without war. Star Trek of today is very, very bleak. It's very, very soulless. And without the hopeful qualities that made shows like Star Trek The Next Generation, Star Trek Deep Space Nine, without the hopeful ideas, the strive to be more than what we are, the strive to be better than what we are, you don't have Star Trek. You just don't have Star Trek. And these new shows are devoid of the hope and the spirit of what made Star Trek, Star Trek. They're not Star Trek anymore. So, in celebrating Star Trek Day, all I can celebrate is Star Trek's past, what Star Trek was. Because Star Trek is a mere shadow of what it used to be. Star Trek has died. And I fear that the hopefulness, that future that we would all want to strive for and be a part of, has been lost. Star Trek's not what it used to be. It's a very contemporary show right now, and it strives to satisfy not the core audience, but it strives for the masses. It has ceased to be Star Trek, and there's very, very little to celebrate in terms of Star Trek Day, because though Star Trek may have premiered back in 1966, it has definitely not continued to strive for those core elements that made Star Trek what it is. And that's a very, very huge sin against Star Trek. A very, very huge sin. And though you may love Star Trek Discovery, you may love Star Trek Picard, you may even love Star Trek Lower Decks, it's not Star Trek. It's only Star Trek in name. Name only. And dare I say that Gene Roddenberry would be very, very dissatisfied with what Star Trek has become. And ultimately, in my eyes, Star Trek is a failure. The current batch of shows are a failure. They do not live up to the gold standard that Star Trek has established. There is no desire to keep Star Trek in the shadow of its former glory. And Star Trek is simply no more. And it's sad that I have to sit here and do a eulogy on Star Trek on a day that should be celebrated in terms of what Star Trek established, in terms of what Star Trek had to say. But that's just how it is. Star Trek's over. It is no more. And all I can say is that it's a damn shame. It's a real damn shame, because more than anything in this day and age, we need what Star Trek once stood for. And that's hope. That's a positive future. That's a better future. And the new Star Trek offers none of that.